is Dr. Harry Anderson. Welcome to theadvicebarn.com. I had a question from a barrel racer. She said, I have a horse that's really a good horse, performs pretty well, but is prone to colic. He's colic several times in the last couple of years. And I'm always worried about that happening again. So far it hasn't been serious, but it could be very serious, and yes, it can be. Well, colic is caused by more than one thing. Colic can be caused by simply errors in feeding. It can be caused by timing of feeding, of too much starchy product in a bad time, or too much at one time, or misfeeding. That is fairly common. But colic can also be caused by weather changes, water intake changes. She mentioned that this is a barrel horse, travels a lot, trailered a lot. They tend to not drink as well as they should from time to time. And if you happen to be on the road, you get a big weather change, cold spell, for example, you may have a double barrel thing going on there. But the bottom line is that the fermentation in the hindgut is such that it produces a lot of gas. That's the most common type of founder that we're going to see in those situations. That can be controlled by reducing the amount of highly fermentable carbohydrate that gets into the hindgut. How do we do that? We change the type of feed we offer the horse. We go from a fairly high raw starch type product to one that is either low in non-structural carbohydrate and high in fiber, or we use one with a very well-processed starch so that the starch is actually digested and absorbed in the small intestine and never reaches the hindgut. How do you do that? The extrusion process is one of the ways that we do that. That's one of the reasons that I started formulating extrusion product for horses, is because we really reduce or almost eliminate that possibility of starch getting into the hindgut and causing the gas or lactic acid formation. So to reduce the incidence or possibility of colic, feed an extruded feed like Total Equine. For more information about this or other topics, please visit theadvicebarn.com.